So when you're ready to get started, you want to go ahead and apply your tourniquet. And I like to put the tourniquet on before I ever put my gloves on, because it's easier to locate your vein if you can feel with your fingers first without the gloves on. So you're going to select the vessel based on the best options that you see in that resident's forearm, probably. And you want the tourniquet to be about 4 to 6 inches from the site. And if, because if you, again, if you put it too close to the site, you can set up to blow the vein. When you're done, and take your time with this part, you know, this, it is well worth your time of finding the best possible vein to ensure that hopefully you have to do only one stick. However, if the rule of thumb is that you never want to do more than 2 sticks per nurse before, if you don't get the IV started on the second attempt, the best practice is to go find a more experienced nurse or a different nurse that can try. So after you select your vein, you're going to go ahead and release the tourniquet while you finish the rest of your setup, because you don't want that tourniquet to be staying on for too long. And keep in mind, too, that it's uncomfortable to have those tourniquets on. Then you're going to do the rest of your prep. So you're going to look at your catheter, make sure that there's no defects from the manufacturer, check it out before you get started. And then you're ready to go ahead and cleanse the site. In this picture, it shows the tourniquet on while they're cleansing. You can either do it with the tourniquet off or the tourniquet on, but again, think about how long it's taking you, and if it's going to be very long, it's better to have the tourniquet released during this part. The best practice now is that you cleanse for about 2 inches in the area that you're planning to do the venipuncture. So the current recommendation is that you clean first in a horizontal plane, then in a vertical plane, and then in a circular motion, starting in the very center where you're planning to insert the needle and work your way out. And then you let that dry real well. Then you're going to put the tourniquet back on. This is the hard part. This is the point that you definitely do need to have your gloves on before you're doing the venipuncture. But it's so tempting to want to touch that vein one more time. If you find that you need to feel the vein one more time, then you have to clean the skin again, because we're using clean gloves, not sterile gloves. And so I think this is one of the areas that it's hardest for nurses, but you do need to keep in mind that if you have to touch the site again, then you need to go back with alcohol or chlorhexidine or whatever your cleaning product is, and keep that in mind. The next step is to look at where the bevel is on your needle, and the bevel should be inserted with it in the direction up. So the bevel is that slanted part of the needle, and it needs to be facing up when you go in. And you're going to use the thumb of your non-dominant hand to be pulling backwards on the vein to help anchor it, because one of the biggest problems with older adults even adults in general, is veins rolling when you enter in, and then it's hard to get into the vein. So you want to be sure that you put backwards tension against the vein with that other hand while you go in with the bevel up. So it's a 10 to 30 degree angle that you want to go in, and as soon as you're going in, you're looking to see a flashback of blood come through, and the first place you'll see it is through the white part of that catheter, and then backwards into the flashback chamber where you can see the blood return. That's when you know that you are in the vein. And once you see that flashback, then you want to bring your angle down more flush with the skin and advance it a little bit more, but not all the way with the needle. So remember, what we're working with is this coating that's over the needle that's going to slide forward into the vein. So you go no more than 1/4 inch with the actual needle, and then you're going to advance the hub of that catheter all the way into the vein. So this is showing how your one hand is going to hold the the needle still, and the other hand is going to be used to push it off into the vein. And once you do that, then you can go ahead and release the tourniquet. And so you're going to just keep the needle there for right now, because as soon as you take that needle out, it's going to start oozing blood. So it's okay just to leave it there until you're ready to reach and connect your IV tubing of whatever kind that you're going to use. And this is very helpful so that you don't have a bloody mess. What you're going to use is that one of finger to hold back above the site. You're going to put pressure down on that vein so that it won't bleed out while you're getting the needle removed and the rest of the parts set up. So you can use your ring finger, the middle finger like it shows in this picture, and then your index finger. I like to even use my index finger and thumb to hold over the vein. And we're going to have a video that illustrates this also, but you can see that it is helpful to put the pressure back over the vein. Now notice too in this picture that they are not putting their gloved finger right over the site of insertion. Remember that you really want to avoid touching the insertion site, because again, you're going to increase the risk of infection. So you need to keep sterile the needle, the hub where you're going to secure the IV tubing to, and the site itself. So then when you're ready, when you have your pressure down over the vein, then you can go ahead and remove the needle. Now, often you're going to be using safety needles now, and so there's likely going to be a button that you'll push that will just automatically retract the needle back into the barrel. If you don't have that, you need to be really careful and take the needle to the sharps container as soon as possible, preferably immediately. And then you can go ahead and attach your tubing or your saline lock. Then you're going to put the dressing down, and you do need the resident to keep really still until you get this taped down well. So if you need to have an assistant with you to help keep them still, be really careful, because it's very frustrating that you've worked very hard to get this IV out, and then your person moves and it comes partially out or all the way out. So you want them to be really still until you get this taped down really well. The current recommendation is that you use the transparent dressing down first on the IV site. And you're going to cover up to the hub of where the extension tubing or the IV tubing comes. Then you're going to use additional tape to finish taping down the rest of it. And don't forget that it's really important that you label your dressing, that it includes the date, the time, the gauge, and your initials. And then, of course, you'll document in the chart as well. But you do want for other nurses to know, and the rule of thumb is that, and again, know your policy, but the standard is that they're good for 72 hours, that are peripheral IV. Is good for 72 hours. Some institutions will let you go up to 4 days, especially if you know that this is an older adult that's difficult to start an IV in, as long as it's not showing signs of infection or infiltration or phlebitis. If the site is good, you may be allowed to use it longer, but you do need to be aware that the longer it's in, the higher the likelihood of complications that can occur. And of course, with PICC lines, those can be used up to a year, I believe. But the peripheral IVs are very short-term use, and then they have to be discontinued and a new one initiated.